I've got Cooper here digging a hole. What you doing, Bugs? It rained all stinking weekend, so there was no barrel races that happened near me. I think they had a super show in Asheville, North Carolina, but that is a ways from my house. Not only that, but I had to take my horse to the vet on one of the running days, so I couldn't really change that, or it wasn't worth changing it to me with how not so well I'm running right now. Also, Honey lost a shoe.
I was planning to leave at 9, but it's 8:55 right now. I didn't realize that. I had some chores to do. And then my Bible study just absolutely sucked me in this morning. But my hair's sort of greasy. I'm thinking about wearing a hat or doing something with this crazy mane. This is just the outfit for the moment. I'm wearing my Kentucky Derby hat, a Georgia sweatshirt, and then Lulu leggings. I really want to go let out the horses before I leave, so I am going to do that.
I'm letting out everybody. It feels really good out here today. It's been interesting all weekend because literally stormed on Friday, was like freezing. Saturday, the sun came out, was beautiful, but it was soaking wet. And it was raining that morning too. And then yesterday was a really nice day too. So we'll just have to see what this week brings us. We're in that awkward time. Like last night I didn't have to put blankets on my horses, but Friday they stayed in their stalls all day and had blankets on all day long. We're just at that awkward time change, weather change. Time actually changes in a week, which means it's gonna be staying lighter later. Yeah.
Let's go, y'all. I'm actually more ahead than I thought I was. It's only 9:07. It takes like 45-ish minutes to get there. So I think I have plenty of time.
I'm basically here. It's 9:57. I'm about to park. I'm not getting out of my car though before 10 because there's already a freaking line and I'm not waiting in that. So I went to the boutique, got pretty good deals. I'm gonna give y'all a haul later when I get home. But I actually stopped for a Starbucks, got my nails done. I just went for a French tip, super plain, super fun.
I realized the other day that my phone freaking blacked out while I was giving y'all my haul from that boutique. So here's your haul. What I got is this little tank top, paid $10 for it. I got this dress, which I think is super cute. Easter's coming up, so I definitely need an Easter dress. I have two options in here, and then I actually have a few more other options that I haven't worn yet. But this is just like a little groovy, it's just giving me like those 80s, 70s, whatever vibes, like hippie vibes. Fun, hippie look. This dress is another Easter dress potential. It's really cute on. It kind of is longer. This shirt to run in, actually, and it was only $12, so I couldn't give it up. These pair of shorts, I just figured they could be fun for the summertime, the beach, something like that. Two tank tops. This one was $9. Always get asked where I get my tank tops in the summer. I get them from anywhere and everywhere that has cheap stuff. Got this bodysuit. I have a blue one like this that I got from Amazon, so I figured I might wear her as much as I wore that one last summer. My favorite part of all, shoes. I got these really cute square-toed boots. I love them. All right, y'all, I just got home. I changed into some Ariat jeans. I absolutely love these jeans. I want them to be a little bit too big just so I can wear them in the summertime. I think I'm going to change my hat. This is one of my favorite hats. I wear it all the time. It is the McIntyre Saddlery. I have this one from them. And then I also have this one up here. Honestly, I might wear that one today instead. I'm excited to share with y'all what I got because I feel like I did pretty good. I got me and my mom a few things. I actually tried on the stuff that I wanted. But let me tell y'all, it was so crowded in there. I wanted to get in and out so bad. It was nothing to like sit around for. It looks like it's gonna be a beautiful day outside too. So I'm glad that I got home. I feel so much more like just
a person now with jeans on and a hat and my hair kind of sort of fixed. Makes me feel good.
I think I want to start out riding Queen today. Last week, I only got to ride her maybe once or twice, which is not near enough what I needed to, but I try to ride her like 3 to 4 times a week. Sometimes it doesn't happen though, because my open horses, my four-year-olds, definitely take priority over her. But I am trying to put more hours on her, get her used to everything, because she, I've talked about it before, but I am debating selling her. So it's just a thought. I need to put more hours on her though before I actually list her or anything like that. My phone is being a pain in the butt right now. It keeps acting like I have no storage, even though I've deleted like so many pictures, so many apps. I'm just gonna lunge her for maybe 20 minutes. Go! For 20 minutes just to get out the spices, especially since I haven't, since I really didn't work her as much as I wanted to last week. We'll just start off slow today. We did 10 minutes loping, 10 minutes lunging on each side. I'm letting her have a little bit of a breather before I saddle her up. I rode her for probably like 30, 40 minutes or so. Now I'm just taking her up in the back pasture, walking her around. She is very excited, as y'all can tell. Just trying to get her used to being back here. She's feeling much better about being out here in general. That was my goal. Now I can probably start riding her out here because she is looking around, but she's not caring too much. And I wanted to walk her through the pasture a few times before getting on her out here, just to make sure we weren't going to have an obvious problem. And it seems, she seems to be doing pretty good and taking it like a champ. Queen worked really good today, actually. It's a little hot out here, to be honest. I started getting hot in my boots, so it feels nice to change into my tennis shoes. But she did good. I think I'm going to go switch the clothes over. I started some laundry this morning. Didn't get a chance to switch it over. And then I might go ride Jazz, see how the arena is, see what's happening over there. I ended up like working with Queen a total of an hour and a half. And I know that sounds like a long time, and it is a long time, but for a horse that's young like Queen, she needs time, a long time, just one-on-one, me and her, whether I be on her back mainly, of course, but also on the ground. She's got to learn ground manners and everything. That's definitely something that she's lacking that I'm trying to enforce a little more, is ground manners. It generally gets better as riding manners get better, and it is getting a little bit better, but we're still working towards it, and I'm trying to make her a better horse. Here are my lazy babies. Oh, please look at May. She's got a briar stuck in her hair, so she's gonna have to have her first haircut today because I can't get it out.
There we go, I'm getting you loose. How did you? Give me one second, give me one second. Mandatory haircut over. Good girl, good girl. Good boy, good boy. Good boy, you were so brave.
This has to go in the trash with her little hairs on it. Got my saddle on my little cart. I really love this golf cart, to be honest. It's so fun. Let's head to my grandma's now. Of course, she's gonna make me walk. I don't even see her yet. Just got old Jazz. The arena is absolutely soaked. I tried to walk her in it and she was sinking. So we're just gonna walk in the pasture today, maybe do some jogging. My round pen is basically all sand. That's why I was able to keep riding Queen in that, even though it rained so hard this weekend. It is so wet in this pasture. I'm kind of confused on why the pasture behind my house wasn't that bad and the one directly beside of it is soaking wet.
She did really good. I got her sweating pretty good, actually.
Not sure if I'm gonna ride anybody else just because it's so wet, I can't really do too much.
Might just wait till tomorrow for Lee and Blaze. We'll have to see. And Honey cannot be rode because she pulled a shoe. I'm going to scoop out my stalls because it is needed. It's been a really chill day, to be honest. But I've really enjoyed it.
I just worked out. And I've been trying to, like, work out twice a week pretty much now. Just because, A, when I was in college, I didn't really have a whole bunch of time to work out. And another thing is, I ride horses, so I'm always moving, always active. Y'all know how it is. You're always doing something. But I really wanted to try to start working out this year. And I've been doing a pretty good job doing it twice a week. There are some weeks, obviously, where I don't get to do it twice a week. But it works out really good because my boyfriend's actually going to, like, be a volunteer firefighter. He has to, like, go to the training meeting stuff twice a week on Mondays and Thursdays until, like, the test, which is in the first week of April or something like that. It's actually around the due date of Ladybug, so it's somewhere around there. With that, I don't hang out with him on those two nights because they get done so stinking late. So me and him don't see each other two nights a week, basically. And those nights, I just take time to, like, clean up, do things I've been needing to do, and also working out.
I've sneezed, like, 900 times this morning. And I just got out of bed. Like, just walked out of my room. Everyone is fed. They're looking really good. Last night, I didn't have to put on blankets. I'm very grateful. I'm sure there'll be a swing, though, whenever, and I'll have to put them back on, but feels pretty good out here right now. I made myself an iced coffee, and I'm going to try these overnight oats vanilla from Trader Joe's. I got these a while ago, and I just have been wanting to try them out. Here's your sign to open up your Bible and read it today. Today, I'm in 1 Peter.
I just threw on some crappy clothes because I'm about to go work with my dad for a little bit. I braided my hair, I think. I washed it last night, so it's a little bit big. That looks pretty decent. Let's go work for a little bit. I ended up washing cabinets today, so I'm really glad that I wore something disgusting and pulled my hair back. I'm about to strip right here because I have Clorox all over me.
My hair's big today because it's so humid out here. It's supposed to start raining tonight at like 9, and then I don't even know when it's supposed to stop. So let's ride queen with that being said. I need to get more like super light sweatshirts like this one is. I feel like I wear this one all the time around this time of year just because it's my only one.
I got Queen out, planning on trying to ride her in the pasture today.
So on Tuesdays and Thursdays, me and my dad actually ride Lee and Blaze together. It's very helpful for him to ride Blaze for me because they both need to be rode. It gives me an extra hour and a half of my day to do something else because he's helping me ride the other one. I'm keeping her moving. We just switched to go to the left. I've also got to teach her how to be hosed off. Her ground manners are not there though, so I'm just trying to add to her ground manners first. Then I'll teach her how to be hosed off.
I got her saddled up. To be honest with y'all, yesterday she was a pain in my butt when I was saddling her. She didn't want to give me her feet. She was moving around like crazy. And today she just calmed down a lot. Today she calmed down so much. I'm excited to get on her. I haven't been wearing my helmet on her in the round pen anymore just because it's so hot. But when I get out of the round pen, I do put it on because we're experiencing new things and you never know what could happen.
Can you see?
She was really difficult when I first started putting her bit in her mouth. She never wanted to take her bit, and we just struggled and we struggled and we struggled. And finally, now, it does take me longer than I would hope, but she's getting better and better every single time I do it.
We'll ride her in here for maybe 30 minutes or so, just depending on how she acts is really how long we're gonna stay in here. And then I wanna take her out into the pasture. I'm so proud of her. We ended up riding in the back pasture, which is the first time we've ever done that. We've rode in the pasture that she's stays in, and we've rode in the pasture, like, they have two turnout pastures, and we've rode in both of those, but we haven't stepped into the farther pasture, which is the pasture between my house and my grandma's house. And she did really good today. I didn't plan to ride out there for too long because it's not about the time right now. It's about just getting her out there and starting new things with her. And she did so good and took it like a champ. I definitely got her sweating pretty good, but overall, I'm very proud of her today.
Finally starting to get somewhere. So that is just exciting to me.
I check on Ladybug pretty much every single day. She went to the vet last Friday. Today is Tuesday. She's good right now. She let me wait 2 weeks instead of 1 week to see her again. So I think I'm seeing her like March the 14th. Look at her mammary development. It's definitely getting somewhere. I've been checking though just to make sure, and it's still like very hard. There's not really like a, like it's not milk yet, which I'm very thankful for. That is edema apparently, just like people get swollen feet when they're pregnant. They get like fat underneath there too. You can actually see the edema more on this side because it's just like, it's skin and it's hard tissue. It's not milk yet. She doesn't have that front little pouch yet. She's still working on that. March 24th, I think, somewhere around there. The end of March is the earliest that she can have this baby with it surviving. But we're supposed to wait until April 11th. Ain't that right, my girl? She's gonna make it the full 11 months. I know it. I'm letting out everybody now. Let me tell y'all, if you have had a broodmare and successfully had a baby, you are very lucky. It's just crazy because we started this process with Ladybug, and at the same time, one of my friends started the process with her mare to get a baby. And her mare, by the time this one is coming out in April, will be 2 years old, and she'll be able to start riding it. And mine's still cooking. I ate lunch. For some reason today though, I'm tired, and I'm definitely contributing it to me doing a lot of stuff yesterday. Drinking Celsius because I'm tired. But I was gonna say, I wish Celsius made half sizes because this, I'm never gonna finish. I've never tried the strawberry lemonade one. Let's try it. It doesn't taste like strawberry lemonade to me. I want to ride Jazz in a little bit and see about the arena, but right now I'm going to scoop my stalls. It shouldn't take long. They're not bad at all. My stalls are cleaned. Now I'm going to go ride Jazz and check on the arena. It's a little bit wet, but I think I'm going to try and ride Jazz on it. Guess who completely forgot her tripod? Got the girl. She didn't make me walk too far today.
Seeing the spiciness behind this mare. She literally has her ears pruned and I'm just standing here.
I wanted to get me riding Jazz on camera, but my papa's here talking to someone, I don't know who, and I got embarrassed and couldn't put up my phone, y'all. I got a nice 20 minute ride in on her, just mainly jogging. The arena is wet. I'm not sure if me and my dad will be able to come over here and ride the girlies, just because having two in there, we're not gonna be able to like avoid the wet spots very good. I need to get some more suspension or something on my golf cart because it is shaking so bad. My Celsius literally spilled everywhere. It's terrible.
about an hour before I need to get the horses ready to go for me and my dad to ride. It actually says it's like raining right now, but it's not. Hopefully it won't like rain us out or anything like that, because those girls really need to be rode.
I only got like 20 minutes worth of editing done before my dad just called me and said he would be ready to ride in 20 minutes. So I'm gonna go put them up. I got up the girls, gave them a little bit of sweet feed to get them up in their stalls, because Blaze is so hard to catch. I wouldn't have to put up everybody if it wouldn't be for her having to be rode today. Everyone is up. I went ahead and fed them, even though it is early, but it's fine. Tonight's not a blanket night. It's supposed to be like a low of 57, so it's supposed to be really warm. I'm gonna get ready and then go to my boyfriend's house.
Tired today. I don't know why. I need a coffee though, so let's go get one.
It rained all last night and it still hasn't stopped.
I just ate breakfast, made me an iced latte with cookie dough syrup. It's good. I'm not 100% sure what I'm doing today, because it's supposed to be basically raining all day, which I actually enjoy rainy days, because it gives me time to like catch up on housework and things. Y'all, my hair has seriously like changed over the past year or so. It's just so much softer, feels so much healthier. It's growing so much so fast. It's crazy. I feel like I just got a haircut the other day and it's already back to the length that it was previously. And I don't apply any heat to my hair, honestly. Like, I even try, if I'm washing my hair, like hair wash day, I'm doing that early so my hair can air dry. It is really, really raining today. I don't know if y'all can hear it or not, but we have a metal roof, tin roof, and it is so loud. Today's just your basic clip day. I'm gonna try to save the rest of my coffee.
Let's go to work now. I just got home. I changed my clothes. I worked on a trailer today with my dad, and I'm about to give hay in their stalls, and then I'll come back down here a little bit and let them out. It quit raining. It's still drizzling a little bit and it's absolutely flooded, but I just want to get some chores done today and we'll see what happens. Everybody's got hay. I did that quickly because I'm hungry. After I left the trailer, I went to Wendy's and got a salad because I was really craving that, but couldn't eat that in the car, so now I'm gonna go eat that. I get the apple pecan salad. It's really good. I caught up on emails. I had so much stuff to do with that. I'm about to let out the horses, let them have a little bit of time outside. It is starting to drizzle, but it's not bad at all. And it also is a very warm day, so they're fine to go out. I just didn't want to put my hay on the ground with it being so nasty and wet and ruin my pasture.
I've pulled out my coffee from this morning that I saved.
I went ahead and put up everyone, fed them, cleaned my stalls. Also, I cleaned my water buckets. That needed to be done. It's been a while since I've like took them out, dumped them out, and washed them. So I got that done. They're looking good. They at least got to go outside for a little bit in the coolness. I just fed hay. I had a nice little catch-up day today and got a bunch of stuff done. So I'll talk to y'all tomorrow.
Let's go feed, and then we're gonna go to my boyfriend's house because we're gonna go fishing. It's 6 a.m. right now. Let's go get the move on.
gonna leave the lights on down here just so they can eat. And let's go because I'm running really behind. We've made it. The equipment is worth more than the whole boat. And it's so foggy out here. I hope he knows what he's doing.
Nope, we're lost.
He's a professional fisherman, so we're good.
You're gonna get me in trouble.
What's that mean?
Oh. I'll tell you, I'll tell you. Or after Adam.
Finally got one. What you think that one is, Joe? A 20 pounder?
14.
Here.
I got
it. Hold up, it's on snap.
Okay.
I'm scared.
Hurry up, it's on my face.
Ah! He's really big. He's fat. Are they pregnant right now?
We've been out here for like 2 hours and caught one fish. Joe says it's not windy enough. They've been playing with him, though. You got anything to add?
Oh, I haven't been here in 2 months, and...
So, excuses.
The water's still in 40.
So, excuses.
We can't put the boat on the trailer. Oh my gosh! We made it out of the water. I just got back home. Me and my dad are gonna ride this afternoon. It's like 3 now, we're gonna ride at 4. So I'm gonna scoop my stalls. First, oh man, he scraped up my pile of horse poop. I'm so glad. Ladybug's scaring me again. No surprise there. I'm supposed to go to the vet next week. Now her teats are getting bigger, of course, but she's not like physically bagging up yet. I'm trying like my best not to panic about things that I can't control, because I definitely can't control this one. It's 4:09. If I decided to rush her to the vet, it wouldn't do me much good anyway. I wouldn't get there before they closed, and I think she's good. These girls are so dirty. Let's get them brushed out. News. I called my vet at home, sent her a picture of what I was looking at on Ladybug, and she seemed more concerned than I was hoping she would be. I'm gonna take her to my vet tomorrow morning to get her ultrasound, to get her looked at. She actually told me to give her Banamine, so I did that, and I don't think there's anything else I can do for her other than pray that she's okay and pray that the baby's okay. She said she was a little bit concerned about placentitis, and that is what happened last time, so that's a little bit scary, but I'm gonna go ahead and give them hay. There's nothing I can do at all, so I'm not gonna be concerned about it. I'm just gonna take her tomorrow morning and do what is in my earthly ability and let God handle the rest of it. I saw like a little weird mucusy drips kind of from Ladybug's booty, and we got done riding, and I noticed that she was kind of acting funny. So she has this baby tonight, you know. Lord willing, she won't, but I did what I could do, I think. I hope. I pray. Good morning, y'all. It's the next day. I got up early, got everybody fed. Gotta go to the vet today to get Ladybug checked out. I walked down here this morning and I was like, please Lord, don't let there be a baby on the ground. Please just let it be holding. And there is not a baby on the ground. She is good. She's still cooking it. And then I was like, oh my gosh, I should be grateful for my days too, because you don't know if you're gonna get tomorrow. Just like I don't know if Ladybug's gonna pop that baby out today or tomorrow or on April 11th when she's supposed to. So I'm just praising the Lord this morning and thanking him for giving us all another day. I'm about to go get ready. I wasn't sure if I was gonna tell you all this because there's like a fine line for me between sharing and like not bragging, but just being too proud of like what's going on. Especially, I want to be sensitive because I know other people went through the same process I did and they did not get accepted. So I want to be empathetic and thoughtful for those people too. But I want to let y'all know that I got into vet school. Applying and everything was a huge process and I wanted to document it really well, but I failed at that because there's so much information and so much stuff that goes into it. It just really wasn't feasible for me to vlog and show y'all what was going on with that. I had to submit my application in September and I got accepted a week ago, which is really crazy. Lots of people don't get accepted. There's less vet schools than there are med schools. So it's harder to even get into vet school than it is med school. But I'm really thankful. I know it was the Lord. It definitely wasn't anything of my doings. I've got the girl. We're walking up to my trailer. I'm just going to take the three horse today, not the big gooseneck. Come on. Mumpy. There you go. I stopped to get a coffee. I ate breakfast at home today because I felt like it was needed. I ate out every single meal yesterday and I just needed something like healthy, so I just ate oatmeal. We had a healthy report. I'm so excited. They said try to hold out for 2 weeks this time. If I notice any change, they'll obviously bring her up here, but other than that, everything looks good. No infection or anything like that, so good to go. I just got home. I just scooped my stalls. I'm thinking about riding Honey because I haven't rode her all week because she's missing a back shoe. And it's just a back shoe, so it really won't affect too much if I just go on an easy bitty trail ride with her because it's too wet to do anything else. And she's out in the pasture anyway. Honestly, I should have took her this week to get her shoed, but I had it in my mind. I have to drive 30 minutes to my farrier's house, get her shoed, and then 30 minutes back home. And I was like, why would I do that when we're both going to be at the horse show and he can just fix it there? But now they're talking about canceling it. Got Honey. She's definitely harder to catch than some. I'm riding in leggings and tennis shoes and it just feels so strange because normally I'm wearing blue jeans, obviously, and with Honey I normally do put on boots, but today's just an easy day. Y'all, it's quite some time later. I went ahead and put up all the girls. Like I had predicted, the show got canceled for tomorrow, so hopefully there'll be a barrel race next weekend. The weather is just not cooperating this weekend. It's supposed to keep raining until like 1 o'clock tomorrow. But thank y'all so much for watching. I'll see y'all next week.